Do your customers sometimes return merchandise that they paid for with cash? Well, in that case, you need to learn how to record cash refunds for sales of merchandise. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. When customers return merchandise, the effect on the accounts is the opposite of the sale. The quantity of the items returned will increase because we just got back more items from the customer. The correct document to create when merchandise is returned from a cash sale is called a refund receipt. So what happens when items are returned for cash? Well, the cash in bank will go down because we just gave back some of our cash to the customer for the returned items. And the sales income will decrease by the sales price of the item because those items were never really sold if the customer turned around and gave it back to us. Consequently, the cost of goods sold will also decrease by the amount that we paid when we bought the items for resale because we just got them back, so they weren't sold, so cost of goods sold goes down. The only thing that increases is the inventory asset, and the inventory asset will increase because we just received back items that were sold. So if we now receive back items from a customer, we have more available for sale in inventory. For example, let's imagine on January 7th, Alan returned two apples from the January 3rd sale receipt. What would be the price of the items returned, or the sales price? Well, we sell the apples for $50 each, so $100 of the sale of the apple is what's reversed. And then what did we pay for the two apples that were returned? Well, we buy them for $10 each, so we paid $20 for the two apples that were returned. So what will be the result of this sale return in the trial balance? Well, we have $100 less in sales, so sales will decrease to $3,400. We have $20 less in cost of goods sold, so cost of goods sold decreases to $680. And inventory actually has $20 more because we just received back merchandise, so that will become $2,820. And unfortunately, because we had to pay them back $100, our negative balance becomes $100 more negative and goes down to 400 credit. So these will be the numbers in the trial balance after we record our refund receipt. And here's the example refund. You must make sure that you put the exact same items on the refund receipt, apples, that you originally put on the original sale receipt. So January 7th, two apples returned from Allen. In the top left, click New and go down below sale receipt to where it says refund receipt. The date is January 7th. The customer returning is Alan. Now the item that is being returned are apples, and we are returning two of them. So the amount we must refund, and where it says refund from, you have to choose which bank or credit card account you're refunding the money from. So that's how you fill out a refund receipt. And then when you click save and close, You successfully issued a refund to Alan. It means that you physically wrote him a check from your handwritten checkbook and you gave it to him. Now, click OK and notice the results are exactly as what we expected. 3,400 sales of product, cost of goods sold 680, inventory asset 2820, and cash in bank decreased to more negative 400. Just to double check, click Reports, Inventory Valuation Detail, and you can see when you go down to the bottom of Apples, it says January 7th was a refund that increased the quantity by 2 apples and increased the cost to $1,220 just for apples.